You may be using ES6 or ECMAScript 2015. Not all browsers support all of the newest features without a transform. The tool that is most widely used for the transformation of ES6 to ES5 JavaScript is Babel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Webpack with Babel Loader. When we use the Babel Loader, we tear the Webpack to use Babel to perform these transformations on specific files. To set up the Babel Loader, we will need to take a few steps. Let's go to the terminal. We are going to install Babel Loader, Babel Core, and Babel Preset Imp, and we will save these to our dev dependencies. The Babel Loader is the loader. The Babel Core is the actual Babel package that handles the transformations. And Babel Preset Imp is a set of rules that defines what should be transformed. Next, we need to make some adjustments to the webpack.config.js. We will add another key called module, and we are going to add another called rules, and this is going to be an array of objects. The next thing we want to do is add an object, and we will then add a test key. This test key is going to set to /\.js$, and it is going to say that whenever a JavaScript file is found, Babel should compile it. We can also define an optional key exclude and set it to /node_modules/, and this is going to say don't run Babel on the node modules folder because it is unnecessary. Finally, we will add another object called use, and we are going to say that this should use the Babel loader. Next, we will create a new file called .babelrc.js, and this is going to set up all of our configuration options for Babel. We then are going to use module.expose function API. Then we will call api.cache true. It will tell Babel to cache the config function execution result to optimize the build process performance. Next, we will add a constant called presets, and it is going to set to a list of presets we want to use with our application. And finally, we will return an object that contains our presets. So let's go ahead and run our build command, which will run Webpack, and it is going to compile our code to the standards of preset imp, which means almost every browser will be supported. If you want to customize this further, you can use the browser list integration. You can be very specific about which browser you want to target. And as you can see, const transformed into var, which is ES5 compatible syntax.